Greetings, everyone, and welcome back to the Java for Beginners series. My name is Brian Benz. I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft, and I'm joined by Rory Preddy, who's going to talk to us about Visual Studio Code. Rory, do you want to tell us a little bit about yourself and about the topic?
Thanks, Brian. I'm talking to you from Johannesburg, South Africa, and today we're going to show you three things to get you started. One, how to install Visual Studio Code. Two, how to navigate all the menus and get started with your project. And three is how to push to the cloud of choice, Azure. So I'm really excited to show you those three things. And by the end of this, you're going to be able to use Visual Studio Code and Azure.
Hello, friends. And today we're going to be going through some very basic install guide on how to get started with Visual Studio Code and also looking at running and debugging your first application and running JShell in the terminal. So the first thing in the links provided, you're going to install the coding pack for Java. You'll get on install a disclaimer to accept the license agreement. Click on next. It'll scan what your requirements are. You can see there I've already got JDK and also the Visual Studio Code installed. And then click on install for it to install your requirements. And then click on finish to launch Visual Studio Code. And you'll be given a blank screen here. So let's just maximize that. And you'll be given a blank screen here. And you can start either open folder, clone or repository. And we're going to go in and create a Java project. Now, we're not going to use any build tools. You can use Maven, Spring Boot, Quarkus, and MicroProfile if you want to play around. But I'm going to click there, no build tools, to go with a sample project. I'm going to specify a basic project that I'm going to start with. So I'm going to call this Java Basics MSFT for Microsoft Foundation, and then select the project location there and give it another name there. I'm going to call that Java Basics. And then you have a very basic file that has been created. You can see there app.java. And if you run that file, it is just going to say hello world. You can click on that little run and debug, and just make sure that everything is set up correctly there. Now what it's going to do here, it's going to use your JDK that is installed with the coding pack, but you can actually change it to install it or to install another Java development kit. So if you go into the command palette, so you go view, command palette, we have a screen there called configure Java runtime. You can click on that, and in there you'll see the project JDKs. You can see there I've got my default is the Java 11 JDK that comes with the Microsoft Open JDK just recently released. And you can also specify the tooling runtime, which is the language server. The language server actually does a lot of the parsing of the language features in the background. You can specify that there and also get a view on your installed JDKs. You can see there I've got 16, 15, 11, and 8. You want to install a new JDK? You can install an adopt JDK here, or you can go and click through others. You can see there's the Microsoft build of OpenJDK. So I've got app.java. Let's create a program using the great IntelliSense that is provided out of the box. So the first thing I want to do is I want to delete that line there, and then I want to create a person object, person p equals to new, let's go there, person. And I want to give that person a name of Bill Gates, the founder of Microsoft. And then I want to go p, let's go sys out, which you can see there, it's got some nice templates, sys out. And I want to go p dot get name to get the name. And then I also want to go hello Bill Gates. So we do that. And then we'll just make sure we've got a space there. So now it's complaining to us that that person class doesn't exist. In the file view there, you can see we only got app.java. So we're going to scaffold out that using the IntelliSense. So you can mouse over person here, and then you can just go there. You can see person P cannot be resolved to type. You can click on quick fix, and then you can go create class person. And it'll create the class there and template it out. And there's really nothing in that class just yet. Then it will say the constructor. You can see person P is not available. So we can go quick fix, and then you can go create constructor. Now if we go into the person class there, it's got a constructor. And lastly, we want the get name. So we can go quick fix, and then create method get name. Now if we run this, it won't really run anything because there's nothing set up in the name. We have to go in and just wire it up. So we want to create there a private string name. And we want to set that name when the constructor goes in to this.name. So we'll set this.name. So it's the instance of the class being created equals to name. We also want to, when we get the name there, we want to return name for the getName method. And finally, we want to use the great refactoring tools, the source action there. You go source action, and then you want to go generate a toString method there. It'll say, what fields do you want to use? You click OK, and then it'll say, yay, that is the person.name. So that's our class done for person.class. Now we want to see it run. So if we run it now, and we haven't put any breakpoints, you can just go run in debug. It should say, hello, there we go, and Bill Gates. Now we're going to put a debug point there, so you can just click on the gutter here, a debug point. We want to actually debug this class here. So you can click on run in debug again, and it should stop where we put our debug points. And now it's using inline variables. You can see there the inline variables are person name equals Bill Gates. And you can change that if you wanted to. You can right click on the variables names there, and you can go disable toString object view or a lot of different options there, hard static variables, and you can actually change it. Now, so you want to then step over and go to the next line, or you can step into. So if we go step into here, then you can get step into here, and you can see that this is going into the Java classes, and you can step out of to go back and step over to go through there. And then we have there the run continue to say, hello, Bill Gates. Last thing I want to show you is how to run J shell. So you can go J shell here in the terminal, and it'll give you the Java shell. A lot of our demos that we're going to run in this series are going to be using J shell. So you can get J shell here and also obviously run the classes as we've shown you here. So that's everything I wanted to show you today. So go to that link, install the coding pack for Java, and then get started, create your Bill Gates object, your person object, and then we'll see you in the next sessions.
Thanks, Rory. That was great.
Thanks, Brian, and we shared so much with the audience on Visual Studio Code.
And please don't forget to check out the rest of the Java for Beginners series.